And so that's one of the things we're looking for out here. And they believe that, if you can see right here, you see how the signal gets a little different right here? Mm-hmm. See how the signal is?
It's kind of dark. It's darker right in there, right?
Exactly.
Ari Lucas is not cutting or fertilizing the grass. He is trying to solve a Revolutionary War mystery. That rolling tool he's using is ground-penetrating radar.
Because we're doing every half meter, we're going to do a transect.
Archaeology students and faculty from the University of North Carolina, Greensboro, are investigating a forest clearing at Guilford Courthouse National Military Park in Greensboro.
So this is saying, hey, there's something unusual
right
here.
Right here, and if you look up here, it has to go across meters. Mm-hmm. Each one of these is, it's about 2 meters. So it tells you actually to come out here about 3 meters. It's kind of where it starts, and it actually kind of goes for about another meter. It's about a meter and a half wide.
Probably evidence of the road.
Exactly.
What do you think when you see that? That's kind of cool.
It is. It's kind of a cool thing about this because, like you said, you don't really know for sure what's underneath the ground. But it makes your imagination go wild. So it's kind of fun because it kind of brings up the kid in all of us. You know what I mean? You're like, what could it be?
Right.
Back on March 15th, 1781, British soldiers fought through 3 lines of American troops and militiamen in the area.
It was all happening through thick woods. And the smoke was hanging in the air, so there was a lot of white smoke in the woods, and people, and there was a lot of what we call small firefights.
Despite having an army half the size, the colonials fought a bloody battle, trying to slow the British advance through the South.
So General Greene thought this was good ground because there were 3 ridge lines he could put his troops on, and then he would have a good avenue of escape. If he didn't win the battle, and General Greene never really expected to win the battle.
Archaeologists want to find what's known as the Retreat Road. It's the path on which General Nathaniel Greene led his troops to escape. While the general area of the battle is known, the specific locations aren't.
And that's what the archaeology really is about, the locations and the artifacts and the telling the story. We don't know the location of the courthouse, and of course, the courthouse is the landmark of the time.
500 British soldiers were killed or wounded. The Patriots suffered 300 casualties and retreated. But it was a costly victory because the British lost almost a quarter of their army. That set the stage for their eventual surrender at Yorktown and the end of the Revolution. Those are the facts, but understanding history is knowing much more than facts. In the past, archaeologists would make sample test digs around a property in hopes of finding something.
We're kind of subtracting from 10, so it's a little different. So we're going to be at 7.
But that random digging is expensive and time-consuming. Examining an area with ground-penetrating radar before digging is much more efficient.
And it sends a radio wave down. And so the whole thing a GPR looks for is change. The more change, the better. So if this was sand all the way down, you would get the same signal all the way down. But if it's a big rock wall or something under there, it'll hit that change. And once it hits that change, it sends a signal back like that and says, this is not what I've been going through. So that's basically what we look for when we're doing that. And we can look, this is the profile. So what you're actually looking at is a slice downward.
It could be a soil change. It could be a rock. It could be a geologic change. So it's just showing us contrast with the Earth's surface.
The data is loaded into a computer, which creates a profile image of what's below ground.
Starting at, say, flush with the ground, which would be here. Mm-hmm. You see that road starting to pop up, that side road that we saw? And as we move through these profiles, we can go down and see other things start to.
So this is going deeper into the
deep. As I move the cursor, I'm moving deeper.
These materials are different kinds of knife blades that you can see here. And here, this went right on a barrel of a musket, of a gun, and then it bolted on there. And what you would put in there is a ramrod. So it's a nice brass piece.
These items were found when the radar detected a concentration of objects, along with what turned out to be a row of stones. Archaeologists dug 11 test pits and 6 trenches near the site. Almost 900 items were brought to the university's archaeology lab, cleaned and cataloged.
X percent are found that relate to the kitchen. I can say how many are related to architecture, how many related to the battle.
The exact location of the retreat road isn't pinpointed yet, but historians have a much better idea of its likely location.
I am very excited by it. And, you know, personal items just bring you close to other soldiers. Soldiers wore rings like this, but so did everyday people. So the hardest thing for us is to be able to hold something up and say, this is definitely a soldier's.
I think it's important to know it, to place this whole landscape in its context.